Wow, it's a privilege to be alive to see this wonderful, beautiful Sunday afternoon. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. This is She Matters with Olufunke on your one and only Fresh Station, Fresh FM, that keeps you fresh all the way. 105.9 in the city of Ibadan. My heart is so heavy this afternoon because of the fact that we have a son that needs help. And I want to encourage every of our listeners to help this young man to leave. One thing I want us to know is that I hate regrets in my life. You know, I hate to say, if I had helped, if I had gotten involved, if I had done something, you know, I would have probably saved a life. So please do me a favor. By the time I explain the need, help me to meet it. Because one thing is sure, you know, I've told myself several times, if I refuse to help someone, somebody else will help that person. And the glory goes to God. Of course, I will not be a partaker of the blessing. And I really, really want all our listeners to be a partaker of the blessing that will come if we can just allow this young man to have life. Once again, on behalf of the CEO of this wonderful station, Evangelist Nkajue Laiyefele, today is the birthday of my producer, Tayo Faleti. Happy birthday to you. I wish you a long life, prosperity, sound mind, sound health. Beautiful things happen in your life, in your home, and in your destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not die. You will live to declare the goodness of God. Once again, I wish She Matters wishes you happy birthday. Wow. My heart is heavy all the time. You know why my heart is always heavy? Because I know that no matter what it is, life is not known by duration. It's known by donation. Parents, husband and wife, neighbors, please don't listen to this program alone. Call your friends. Call your acquaintances, call your enemies, because if you allow your enemy to have information, the enemy will not hurt you anymore. So please call your friends, call your neighbors. Hey, well, I've stopped interpreting for a very long time. So help me to interpret. Call some people around you, grandma, grandpa, and help me to tell them what I'm saying. I find out that interpretation takes me a little bit back, you know, when I have a lot to drop to us. And if you have a question, we're going to take questions again today. When you are asking, please ask intelligent questions. Ask what you need to know. Don't, you know, contribute. If I want contribution, maybe I'll use a whole day to do that. I don't want contribution, please. I just want you to ask questions. Of course, DJ Koka, Shem Koka is here in the studio, you know, trying to make sure that we dot the I's and we cross the T's. But one thing is sure, do me a favor. I want you to listen to this burden in my heart, and I'm going to send the account number to you. There's a young man that has so much future, so much destiny, but he's been afflicted by sickness. He has gone through the first surgery, and he needed to do the second one. And sincerely speaking, the parents cannot afford $75,000 that is involved. Okay, Tolu is here with me in the studio. I want you to read that information to the public so that they can hear, and I will read the account number myself. I want you to help that person. You know, when somebody was saying, but you were hungry, I didn't give you food. I gave you food. You were naked, I didn't give you house, you know? And Jesus said, if you can do it for one person, you have done it for everyone around me. So helping someone to fulfill destiny, helping someone to be able to stand out in life and survive and live, is something that is going to be in your record. I noticed that books of remembrance are always opened. You know, I'm sure you know that Nicodemus has been doing every good that he could do. But one day, the book of remembrance was opened. The same thing with Cornelius. You know, when you keep giving, when you keep sowing, somebody said if you keep weeping on the floor, it's going to smell. My prayer for you today is that in the process of time, the odor of your giving towards this child will smell, even beyond your children. Who knows whether your children's children, somebody is going to have a need too. And that need has to be met. So please do me a favor. I'm using this first segment in this program to speak my heart so that I can flow. I'm a mother too. I'm a grandmother. It could be anybody. Please do something as we read this, the information about this child. Go ahead. Tolu, please go ahead.
Okay, Ma. Baby Benedict, a five-year-old boy, was born in Nigeria with Hirschsprung disease, which is a condition affecting the large intestine and causing difficulty in passing stool. He underwent ileostomy at Eagleton Hospital 11 months ago, and the little boy has done well since then, except for increasing protrusion of the ileostomy stoma, which is a surgical opening, making the pediatricians in Nigeria to get concerned that the baby is not tolerating the surgical opening and that it might be time for ileostomy takedown and the definitive procedure has to be performed. The cost of the procedure is about $75,000, which is 27 million naira. It's scheduled to...
Wait, Olu, we need 27 million naira. I was trying to do some analysis that if 10,000 people will give us 10,000 naira, we go a long way. And to some, 10,000 is what they take to club. They drink. They just go to one of the eatery and spend 10,000 naira. Why can't you just drop that and just give another child a life? That will go a very long way. Go ahead.
Okay, the surgery is scheduled to hold on the 23rd of March, 2018, at Eagleton Children's Hospital.
That's how many
Hospital.
Weeks to go? Just less than
2 weeks.
2 weeks. Wow. Please get this account number. Take your pen. Take your papers. Take your phone. Go online and just keep doing the transfer, please. I feel like crying, but I'm not going to cry. It's again, Dick Jekuka will not allow me to cry or else, because my heart is heavy. If it's my son or my grandson, would I not do something? 10,000 with 10,000 people. And I know I have over 10,000 listeners on Fresh FM. On She Matters, I know I have more than 10,000 because sometimes when I finish the program, crowd troops into my phone. So please use this opportunity. If you don't have 10,000, you can give me 5,000, you can give me 2,000. But at least I want lump sum of people to give me 10,000. And that will go a very long way. Thank you so much. Go ahead, Tony.
The procedure is scheduled to happen on the 23rd of March, 2018, at Eagleton Children's Hospital in Atlanta. But the money must be raised because the parents cannot afford the cost of the surgery. Please help with the cost and give Benedict a gift of life. He will not survive without the surgery. Please help the little child. Please.
Wow. The account number you're paying this into is to Diamond Bank 00920738848. And the account name is Yinka Ayefele. I'll read that again. Diamond Bank account 00920738848. Name, Yinka Ayefele. I'll say the last time for now, probably towards the end of the program, I'll still mention it. You can send your donations to Diamond Bank 00920738848. Account name is Yinka Ayefele. Life is not known by duration, is known by donation. Please contribute your own. Donate your own. Let it be in your record in heaven that, or in Alujono, that God used you to give life to Benedicta. Well, my name is Olufunke Adetuberu. Let's go on this music break. We'll be right back. Thank you. There's something I'm seeing here in this studio. DJ Shenkoka is just dancing, confessing that she's a woman. Well, he's a woman. It's not a problem. The hand that runs the cradle rules the world. Every man slept in a woman's womb. I really appreciate him for dancing like that because he understands that the root of every man, there's no man that jumped from heaven. All of you, you slept in the womb. We fed you. We did not know you. The placenta was the dining table. The little mama, blah, blah, that you are talking. Men around, women around will not understand. The first few words you are speaking, we are the one that interpreted it. You say, I want to eat. You may be speaking Greek to somebody else, but it's the woman that interprets your dream, interprets your joy. Ah, wow. If I have to come again, I must come as a woman. I can't miss the joy of being called a mother, being called a destiny helper, being called a destiny molder, being called a voice of a child in her generation. Oh my God, something happened sometimes ago. I stumbled at the scriptures. I can never recover from that scripture. One daughter, she lost her two boys and they wanted to bury those boys. And for 6 months, she was finding the corpse of the children, removing flies. Immediately, the king said, go and bury these children properly. That's a woman for you. When a woman makes up her mind, she's very dangerous. A woman is a pillar of support. I tell men, if your wife tells you it's going to be better for you, go and be sleeping and be snoring. May your wife not tell you, we shall see what become of you. Honestly, that's a troubled journey. It's not going to be a good journey at all. And that's why every man must be smart enough to handle their relationship. Whatever the price you have to pay, and to pain to make your wife happy, to make your wife believe in you, to make your wife your queen. Honestly, the price is not too high. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. Once again, this is She Matters with Olufunke on your one and only station, Fresh FM 105.9, right in the city of Ibadan. Tayo Faleti, happy birthday. And on behalf of this CEO, I welcome you once again. I've been so passionate about the family system, and you know that is my heart. There are so many children that came from a very dysfunctional home, and because of their dysfunctionality, it has affected their health, it has affected their wealth, has affected their happiness, and of course the happiness of their children is also affected. And that is not the counsel of the Creator. As a matter of fact, the first institution that God created was a marriage institution. Outside that, there's no other institution. That is why the devil comes vehemently to affect and to afflict pain in such homes, because he knows that if he can get the family, he has gotten the whole generation. Everybody stems from a home. And you know, when a child comes from a dysfunctional home, there are lots of things that we see, a lot of symptoms. And I need to quickly tell parents, if you are listening to me, maybe you are in different suburbs, different areas, please, we have pedophiles everywhere. Who is a pedophile? An adult that is preying on the little children. They are pedophiles. Be careful. Teach your children how to sit well. They should put their knees together when they are sitting. They should comport themselves. When you have a child that is jumping on men, jumping on their necks, and just, you know, playing around men, I'm not saying some children are naturally, they are extroverts, but you still have to caution them. You have to tell them that this is not ladylike. A lady does not do this. A lady does not do that. Because, you know, if that is not done, you're going to allow one uncle, one big daddy, big grandpa somewhere to pray on your children, and it's very, very dangerous. And parents, I want you to be sensitive. There are a lot of homes that incest is being practiced in that home. Cousin, uncle, even siblings having to, you know, sexually harassing each other in the same home. And it's so unfortunate that parents, we assume a lot. I mean, if you have boys that are grown up, separate their rooms, please. Don't expose your girls to another boy who is just growing up to a stage of awareness. I'm trying to be careful with words. A stage of awareness, trying to say, okay, I'm a man. I wake up in the morning, I feel like a man. I'm sure you understand what I'm saying. And you have a daughter that is just there, innocently sitting, sleeping there. Anything can be going on in the night. Parents, be careful. I've been handling some cases lately that is puzzling me and is rocking me to my root, to my foundation. And that's why I'm so, so passionate about this. Recently, a lady told me that a four-year-old child will always go to her 1.5-year-old sister. That most of the night, when the baby is with pampers, that is a 1.5-year-old child is with pampers. By the time the day is breaking, almost all the night, the pampers would have gone out of that 1.5-year-old girl. Because the brother goes to her bed. It's scary. And the first question is, who do you leave your children with? Mothers, fathers. I agree that you are busy. You can be busy and be barren. You can be busy and be honestly useless. I'm being honest with you. Because listen to me, when you come back from work, find out. Ask your children questions. You can't afford to take care of somebody's head and something else will take your head away. Ask questions. Especially when your children have been getting an awareness of who they are. I'm trying to choose my words. Getting aware. I'm a girl. I'm a boy. Acting that, you know, she's trying to giggle like a lady. The guy is trying to pose like a man. They are battling with a lot of questions. Confront her with questions. And that's why I'm worried about daddies that are not always home. I've said it somewhere today in church. I said, I have adult daddies. That when it is 6:30, 6 p.m. in the evening, after work, they pack in different brothels, different clubs. They have kids at home that needed to answer, that needed a lot of questions that they need to answer. Dad, what about if I wake up in the morning and my whatever stands up, how do I handle it? And those questions are seated there. Forget it. Leave tradition or whatever. Those questions are in their minds. If they are probing, they have a lot of questioning, something that they're probing they're just inquisitive and nobody is there to answer them. So they start having answers from their friends, from their neighbors, from one child that is or her life is messed up. And look at you. You will not be telling me, hey, I don't know how my daughter got into this. I don't know how my son got into this. Well, you are not going to ask them questions. When they are getting mature, your daughter came back from school, have a lot of makeup on her face and all of that. And you notice that she's trying to be nice. She's trying to be cautious of herself. She wants to wear a bra. She wants to wear some clothes that are showing her curves and all that. And you are not aware that this is the time to wake up. Daddies, mommies, hear me. I'm saying it now because the level of exposure that we have in this generation is scary. Do you know that I had an interview with some young children? They were all addicted to masturbation and pornography. And I asked them, what was their first exposure to porn? It was with their friends on their phone. It was some of them with their teacher. They go to their teacher's class, open the laptop. They're watching what the teacher is watching. The teacher is engulfed with whatever the man is watching, and the kids just stumbled into it. And that is what damaged their sexuality. And today they're struggling. Please, I want to appeal to you. If you're listening to me today, you are a father, you're a mother. Please go home early. And when you get home, ask questions, check your, give your children's diary. One of my daughters in Lagos gave her daughter a diary. The girl was just 5, had a diary in her hand. So several times the mother would just check her diary. And one day she said, I hate Uncle So-So-So that take me to school, that takes me to lesson after school because he was touching my labs. Oh my days. I made that boy to be
to be reprimanded by the police because a child of 5 cannot lie. Thank God for the diary. I hate Auntie So-so, she shouts in class. Fine. But whatever, if the child cannot confront you, can you get them diaries from age 4? If they can write 5, 6, 7, let them write something down and make them comfortable. And I have parents hearing me today. Your son, your daughter is not comfortable to tell you anything. It can, you are too busy. You are too naggy. You are not there. You are a shadow dad, a missing in action dad, a boundary buster dad, a traditional dad, and of course, a critical dad. When you keep criticizing someone, you are good for nothing, you are this, you are that. It's a dysfunctional system. When that child wants to ask a question that will determine the future of that child, the child will not have enough confidence to come and ask you questions. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. It might be a little bit hard, but that is just the truth. I'm worried. I'm really, really worried. Things that people bring to my table every day scares me about lives of children, lives of families that are going down the drain, and nobody is ready to say, come, let's hit it and let's hit the nail on the head. I'll be right back after this music break. Thank you so much for listening to me. Please, just make sure that you're listening. Don't do it alone. Call someone. I hope you're interpreting. Thank you.
Fresh 105.9 FM. Invigorating.
Forward-looking parents today invest in world-class education for their children. Our curriculum at Bodija International College prepares students for upward mobility as global citizens. Bodija International College is situated in a beautiful environment most favorable for learning at Plot 125, Tunde Lakomi Crescent, Oshuntoku Avenue, Old Bodija, Ibadan. Our avant-garde structures, sports, modern classrooms, libraries and laboratories, neatly packaged for friendly interactions. We offer secure and comfortable boarding facilities to boys and girls. Top-grade instructors passionately guide our students to success in Nigerian and international examinations.
Here comes another golden opportunity to enroll your wards for the 2018-2019 entrance examinations, holding on Saturday, 10th of March and Saturday, 16th of June 2018 at 9 a.m. in the school's premises. For more information, call 0816-606-1632.
Bodija International College, the best foundation for success.
Fresh 105.9 FM, invigorating.
I welcome you back to She Matters with Olufunke on your Fresh 105.9 FM. I said fresh because it keeps you fresh all the way. Amazing station. Amazing station. Full of life, full of information. So dynamic. I want to encourage you. Please tune in 24/7. Actually, I'm so addicted to that station. It's an amazing one. Well, I'm so burdened, like I said, about the lives that goes on around us. And some of these things that I'm talking about, nobody talks about it. Nobody brings it out to the open. And before you know it, you just notice that your kids are acting funny. They are doing things that you're wondering, where did I get it wrong? What made this girl to get pregnant in secondary school? What happened? Why? I thought she's a virgin. I thought she's a virgin. You missed it somewhere. You missed it by being careless. And one of the things that truncates the life of a child in a dysfunctional home is when you verbally abuse them. There's verbal abuse, there's a psychological abuse, there's emotional abuse, and of course, there's a sexual abuse. I've talked partially on sexual abuse. What about verbal abuse? You wake up in the morning, the next thing you are giving to your children, you think you are just being, you know, there's a culture that they said it cause people naturally. Please change. There was this tree that was planted, both were planted. And it was, you know, they were watching it with curses and the other one was with blessings. And the one that was watered with curses withered. And the one that was watered with blessings flourishes, blossoms. If you keep watering the life of your children with curses, you're good for nothing. It can't be this, it can't be that. You are this, you're that. And you don't have caution because you are angry. Listen to me. For the fact that you are 30, 40 does not make you a man. For the fact that you can impregnate a woman does not make you a man. For the fact that you have your period as a woman and you lactate after you are pregnant does not make you a woman. Womanhood is the ability to hold your emotions and temper tantrums. It's the ability to hold yourself, even in the midst of serious storms, and tell yourself, mm-mm. You have to be unglued. You have to learn to separate issues. Because a lot of us, the moment there's a problem in the family, the grasses are suffering. Where to elephant fight? Grass suffers. The children knows that something is wrong. They look at you, you cry, you sob in the corner and say, Mom, as that man, they call your husband names. Has he done that again? You think you are, somebody is helping you to massage your ego. You are deceiving yourself. You are crushing. You are mentally, emotionally, physically, psychologically abusing those children. And children that are like that, that are from such a system, they won't know why they are dancing to a music they did not play, know who is playing the rhythm. They just keep dancing. How do I mean? They keep acting funny. They keep stealing. They keep lying. They keep, you know, doing things that you can't even comprehend. When you see a child that keeps lying, that child is from a dysfunctional home. The child is afraid of being killed. I'm quoting that one now. Being crushed, being beaten. So the only way out of that wicked act is to just keep telling lies. So if your child is now a liar, pathological one, then you know that you caused it somewhere. So you have to build that confidence back. Build it back. Tell your children, if you tell me the truth, I'm not going to beat you. And if you promise not to beat your child, don't beat that child. Let them be able to trust you back so that they can leave. Because if they can't trust you, you need to trust someone to tell the truth to that person. That's the gospel truth. I mean, if I fear you, I won't tell you the truth because I know you will crush me. You will hurt me. I have a friend. She's my only friend. I tell her everything. She tells me everything. She still believes in me that I'm a woman of God. That's how it is. Even when I'm wrong, you understand? Because I know that she believes in me. If you believe in your children, you believe in them, you believe in their weaknesses, you believe in their strength, you believe that they can bring the best out of life, you will encourage them to come up with the truth. And when they do that, you will have peace in your heart. And listen to me, if you tell them, I'm going to smack you, make sure you smack them. I've seen mothers, especially women, their children does not listen to them again because I beat you, I beat you, I beat you, I beat you has become a usual song in the family. So they don't believe you again. Stop using I'll beat you, I'll beat you, I'll beat you. Don't let it become a cliche. Don't let it become, you know, your norms in the home. If that is the case, forget it. Honestly speaking, they will not believe you anymore. When you say you're going to beat a child, make sure you beat that child. That's how it works. My children, when they were growing up, that's what I'll beat you, I'll beat you. And I don't promise. If I promise, my word is my bond. I have children listening to me and their parents today that their children can never believe in them because they've never said anything that is the truth again. Okay, keep quiet. I will take you out. You are not taking the child out. You think they are not like us. They are kids. They are babies. Even if they are 12, 13, 14, they are children. They want to be able, you are their role model. You are their hero. You are everything to them. They want to believe their hero, that their hero meant what he said. The moment they see you as a liar, whether you are conscious of it or not, I've even seen some parents, the moment they have visitors, they tell them, I'm not at home. So what are you doing? And a child that lies will steal, will do other things. What are you trying to do? I can't cry over spilled milk, but begin to change now. Begin to work on the way you raise your children. Don't teach them to lie indirectly. It does not work. Are you listening to me? And you know, when you have done that in their formative years and they are set, you are not complaining. Oh, your money is stolen. Your this is gone. Come on. As you lay your bed, so you will lie on it. Well, I'll be taking some calls now. If you are calling me, call me on 080-3232-1059. We have callers already. 080-3232-1059. Or 080-7777-1059. And if you're listening to me for the first time now, I've made a plea and an appeal to some people to assist us to give baby Benedicta a future in the area of his health. Please, the donation goes to, I don't want to go back to details now because we have callers already. You can send your donations to Diamond Bank, 00920-73848. Please make sure you do that and God will bless you. If 10,000 people will give 10,000 naira, it goes a long way. Hello. Hello, good afternoon. Where are you calling? Please, if you are calling us, can you just move away from your radio set so that we can hear you properly? We lost that because of that. Hello?
Hello, good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon, sir. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Gbaro, Ago area.
Go ahead, sir. Here. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah. Please, I have a question.
Yes,
my name is Pastor Akinolu.
Yes, sir. Go ahead with your question.
Yeah, please, a situation by a child grew up to some certain state, like 18, whereby he did not grow up.
Please, move away from your radio, Daddy. I'm hearing you properly, but still move away from your radio.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Please, I have a son. He is not with me for a long time, but he is now 18. And I'm giving advice. He's not more ready to listen to me. What should I do, please?
Daddy, you've actually missed the season of formative years of that child. That's the basic truth. Now, what you can do, sir, is to be his friend. Start with friendship. Forget criticism, forget training, forget teaching. Be friends. You know how you relate with your friend? Some of your friends are bad friends, but you relate with them. If you start being his friend, let's talk together. Oh, yeah, let's play games together. Go and buy Ludo. Let's just be friends. Now, in the process of friendship, the child feels secured. Because the child did not even know you as a dad to start with. They have used you to threaten him. You know, the way Africans, the way we train our children, we think we are, you know, have you noticed that when we're growing, they always want us to be afraid. They set us with the spirit of fear. Ojuju, fear. They are setting us up with fear. In the fallen nature alone, we have fear. One of the things that Adam said to God when he was apprehended after eating the fruit by his wife, he said, I heard your voice and I was afraid. So fear itself has opened the door. Now, raising a child and say, Ojuju is coming. Something is coming. Something is coming. You're messing up the mind of that child in the area of trust and in the area of believing in the negative part of the supernatural. So, sir, be his friend.
Yeah.
Play games together. Go out together. Please forget about his weaknesses. I'll be comfortable with you. There. So when you are chipping in, he won't see you from once daddy God that is somewhere to kill him. He will see you as my friend and teach him about life. Some of these things, you can use other things to illustrate your communication to him instead of coming straight and coming with Koboko and Kane. Thank you, sir. Hello? Yes, I'm with you. Hello? 08032321059 08077777. Yes, ma. Who is on the line and where are you calling from?
Hello?
Yes, I'm with you, sir. Ma. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, I'm with you, ma. I'm with you, ma.
Good afternoon, ma.
Yes, good afternoon, ma.
This is Mommy Usman from Olulayo.
Go ahead, ma. Go ahead, ma.
Okay. Thank you very much. What you have been saying this morning, I'm not with you before, but I just want to raise you now. I hear all what you have been saying. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma.
Some people, some...
Ma, I don't want contribution. Parents. I just want... I want a question. Please, hello. Please, if you're calling us, I don't want you to contribute. I just want questions. The reason is that we don't have all the time. 1 hour is not enough for this program, so I try to maximize. Hello. Good afternoon, ma. Please move away from your radio set. It's really interfering in the studio. Hello.
I just question.
Oh my God, we lost that. Let's pick another one. Hello, if you are calling us, move away from your radio set and please don't contribute. I just need a question so that I can help. One question will answer 500 people's questions. We'll answer them. Yes.
Hello.
Hello, who is on the line and where are you calling from?
This is Olufunke from Abuja.
Go ahead, ma.
So, in the situation, I want to talk about husband and wife, not a side matter now.
Go ahead. Any question, please.
Okay, in a situation whereby a husband is telling his wife, my wife, I love you, but I'm just addicted, and I cannot, and I know your state. You cannot come to my level, so I have to go out to look for a destiny. In a first way, what should the wife do?
Okay, Eshegon, I try like to say Yoruba, dear. The man has sexual addiction problem. Let me quickly say this to that man. I'll be honest with you. Any man that keeps going out of his home is playing with his glory. Sex is not a contract, it's a covenant. If you cut covenant, you know, how do I mean? When you have sexual relationship with a woman, after release, it's blood that turns, that water turns to blood. So you have actually you have released blood. It's blood that is released. Now, if you now have such soul ties, soul blood, your blood is distributed to 300 women, 300 wives, 700 concubines, and 1,000 mother-in-laws, like Solomon. You know what that means? You are entering, you are perpetuating, you are putting problem into your generation. It's tough for a man to continue to do that. But ma, let me tell you something. If a man tells you that, if the man is a child, automatic by Jesus, if he's a born-again Christian, is different. But some born-again Christians sleeps around. They even do it more because they go through the circle of shame and pain. That's what I do. But the point is that the moment you notice that this person is not ready to change, ma, don't let your heart be broken. Hold your heart and start to live your life. And please beg him, because you have told me that you cannot do with one woman, please use condom. I beg you, sir. You can't be in your house and your neck is broken. Let him protect himself. Not that you are his wife. There's nowhere you can go as an African woman. But protect yourself so that you will not have a lot of pain. I have women that have rushed to my life. I say life deliberately. Telling me that my husband gave me HIV and I've never slept outside my marriage. So use something to protect yourself. Allow him, it's your husband. If you can't allow him, go ahead and allow him. If he's your husband, I mean, as long as he's your husband, but protect yourself and protect your heart, your heart. Don't keep getting upset. Let him do what he wants to do and keep praying for him. If you keep praying for him, God can touch him. But please, don't be mad and don't have HIV. Make sure he's using something. Then, finally, make sure that you are making yourself looking good. Make yourself happy. Don't start looking as if you're a 75-year-old woman when you are just 35. Mm-mm. Look good. Take care of yourself. Eat well. Do exercise. Look nice. The business is his own. If you still look good for him, and let me tell you to men, there's no woman that has gold around her own. It's the same thing. I don't know what you're looking for. It's in the brain. Addiction is a brain problem. And you can tell your husband to send me a text on 080-232-42389 if he's willing to change. Thank you for calling. Let me take another call. Hello? Hello, who is on the line? Please, if you are calling us, move away from your radio set so that we can hear you.
Hello, good afternoon, ma.
Hello, good afternoon, sir. Where are you calling from?
This is Nitala, I'm calling from Oyo.
From where, sir?
From Oyo.
Okay, go ahead, sir.
I listened to your program this afternoon, and I want to ask, what about the mothers that do not have much time for their children? And they wake up in the morning, all these to go to work and come back very late in the evening. And you just see the father.
Sir, they are playing with their future. Because sincerely, a woman is a builder. She's supposed to be home. That's why in the olden days, it is the woman that stays at home. Most of the jobs they choose, the teaching job that they will close at 2, by the time their kids are coming back from school, they are also there. Most career women, hear me. In the next 10, 15 years from now, you will know what I'm talking about. Especially now that we are living in a generation that a man must bring money, a woman must bring money, all of them must hustle, and you are not thinking about your children. You've dumped your children in the boarding house. You dump them everywhere. You just make them to do what they are. You are going to regret it. If she's a career woman, she must create a day. Let us assume that she had to work, basically. Maybe your financial state is not too good, and the two of you had to do something. On a Saturday, no party. Let the president be doing party, and they've given her all the ashwabis. She's not going. You cannot hand over the driver's seat of your life to somebody else. It's a time to sit with your kids and understand their weaknesses and their strengths. Understand the friends that are influencing them positively or negatively. You must create time for your children. They are your future. As a woman, they are your future. There's little or nothing much that a man can do, basically. All I want is that a man should be there to give direction, to give instructions, and to be friends with his children so that he can really get close to him. But all the details, clean your pants. I was in a banking hall this week. Come and see grown-up men. Their armpit was smelling like as if you're in the toilet. And I said, come on. Parents are not there. It's not as you can, as a young man, you can shave your armpit here. You don't have to smell for the world. When you sweat, you smell. If you see the kind of clothes that people walk, go out with, you wonder, do they have parents at all? And that's the truth. Parents have to be, and that is the formative stage. When a child is now formed, what would you do? It has become a dry fish. To bend it is to break it. So mothers, please take care of your children. Hello? Oh, dear. Hello?
Hello, good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon, ma. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Oyo.
Yes, this go ahead. Don't continue, ma.
Please, I have a question.
Yes, ma.
I have a sister who got married like 2012 or so.
Yes, ma.
She got married to the man and she didn't know that the man had a child outside.
Okay.
Even all the family don't know that the man has a child before proceeding to for the wedding.
Hmm.
So after the wedding, the lady gave birth to a twin. Like 1.5 years after the wedding, we now detected that the man had a child outside. We called the sister that, did you know about it? She also said yes. But she wanted to quit the relationship. That was when her husband told her that, please don't disgrace me. Don't allow me to be disgraced among the society. Let us go for this wedding, which she agreed then. But she said immediately 3 months after the wedding, she realized that, oh, I'm in hell. Because she didn't trust the guy anymore. Yeah. She noticed that the husband normally go back to the lady, which she said, it is a mistake. You get. So later on, she left the man. She went back to her mother's house, which they accept as, you know, as a Christian stuff. So now, presently now, the lady, as in, she's the only one living with the twins and her grandmother. They take care of the child from the child, old child, till 5 years now. Those twins we call clock 5 years now. You know, she's the only one living. She does not have any comforter or anything. She just even got a job for the past 4 years. She was not contemplating. She now met a guy now. She was not contemplating of remarry. When she told me that, Aburo, I wanted to remarry you, I got a man, let me introduce you to him or something. The first question I asked her was that, is she married? Is he married? You understand? He now said, yes. I said, Yahweh, Nko. She said, Yahweh, oh, she ran. He told me that, Yahweh, man, she ran. But this person had a job. Only Shaggy the law. You understand?
I do.
And he's capable. Last year, you know, I can't me they done a complete and what to be for see Shaggy and all them who can manage me. And this person will look on comfort me by although now last 5 years, Timotikuro Lodor first husband, anybody she me lash or so I said thank God. For me, I don't know, as in, I was now contemplating that, is it right for us to go and marry such a man that had a wife, but he said the man is fornicating, as in the woman is fornicating, that's the reason why he wants to get married to another person.
Thank you so much. Maybe you should just leave the radio so that I'll be able to answer the question. I can't finish that question today because it's highly fragmented. Now, I used to tell people that the eye that will follow you to the grave will not be bringing water in the morning. When you are in a relationship and there's a lie and there are secrecy, you are exposing yourself. If you are listening to me this afternoon, bring everything to the table. If the person is interested in you with your weaknesses, with your clauses, whatever it is in your life, the person will go ahead and marry you. If nothing is at stake, as okay, he's a Christian, he's not a Christian, religion and everything is not there. That is number one. Number two, the moment that happens, trust is violated. And relationship is built on trust. And trust is not demanded, it is earned. You earn it. You prove to your world, to everybody, that you're trustworthy. So now that trust is messed up, and she had twins, and later she discovered, you know, that the man is had a child somewhere. That is number two. Number three, this sister that is going to remarry, can I be honest with you? Most second, third marriages does not work. Go and ask those that are divorced. They will tell you. It does not work. The devil, the man did not conquer in the wife that is at home. He will not conquer it in any woman. Because you two, you know that you are going into that marriage because of need. Who has helped me to carry my bukata? Excuse me. The day that woman is pregnant of another child, that's the beginning of trouble. Because the man has baggages at home. And you know when somebody is, nobody lies to himself. When somebody is telling you, my wife is this, my wife is that. Ijalode lorido weo. It's not like that. It takes you to fight and it takes you to tango. If you look at it very well, now there are seven stages in every relationship. The honeymoon stage, the stage of realization, the nagging stage, the avoidance stage, the explosive stage, the divorce stage. Maybe they were in an explosive stage in their relationship and he's now saying that, you know, he's committing adultery, blah, blah. Maybe it was not the truth. He might not even be saying the truth. A man that goes out of his home to go and meet another woman to say, I want to marry her because my wife is committing adultery. Adultery can be restored in a relationship. The next thing is not separation. You can go because somebody has done something wrong. That is the truth. And the children are in that relationship. The children are going through hell. They're going to suffer it. Where two elephants fight, grass is the one that suffers. Two people in any relationship, when they find themselves and they have issues with trust, the twins are themselves are going through pain. They needed their father figure. Leaving that man would have just been get a counselor, somebody that is professional to assist in that relationship, and you have peace in the relationship. But the moment you are now saying, okay, let me go and look for another person, I can tell you professionally speaking, I've done this for 32 years of this year, with 33 years of my life. I can tell you that the cane they used to beat the wife that is at home is not kept again in the ceiling. It's kept under the bed. By the time there's a conflict, they will just pull it from the bed and begin to whip the new woman. So please, I will advise the person to take counsel. Counsel is might. In the multitude of counseling, there's safety. You can't go to war without counseling. Now, different stroke for different folks. Probably is the truth that the woman actually had, you know, the woman is having an affair. Well, there's a way to still do it because, number one, that man that wants to marry Mama Ibeji now, take it or leave it, has issues with trust also. To trust another woman with his heart is questionable. I was having the graduation of the School of Ministry, and one husband said, he said, I've made up my mind to torture women because of what I've been through. You know, once beaten twice shy, when somebody had hurt you before, you keep going on and on in that relationship to keep hurting other women until somebody comes to apprehend it. And that's why counsel is very, very important, ma. Please encourage her to seek counsel. Yes. Hello. Hello.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. Where are you calling from? Who's on the line?
From Challenge. I'm Solomon.
Go ahead with your question.
I don't know. It's not like I like sex, but I masturbate.
You masturbate. Okay, send me a text on 080-232-42389. Just send me a text on that number. That's my private number. 080-232. Don't call me. Please send me a text. This line is going to, the battery will just die now. 080-232-42389. Okay. So please send me a text. I don't want to talk about that on air. Yes. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello, good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon, Ma. Where are you calling from?
It's here today from Ayo.
Okay, go ahead.
I want to ask a question on what you said last week.
Last week, okay.
Last week, Sunday.
Go ahead.
Concerning the husband and the in-law with the wife.
Okay.
is that the situation that happened to one of my friends. Our in-law is living with and that in-law.
Is it the mother-in-law, or the brother-in-law, the sister-in-law, the siblings?
The mother-in-law.
Okay, okay.
So he likes talking what is not true around the house, from one house to another, from that lady, on the white chap. So it's not happened one day that he talks around the,
Okay, ma.
So, ó fẹ́ràn lẹ́ran kan lòún fi jẹ. So, ìgbà tó sọ yẹn tó ṣá, ìyàwó gbọ́, and now call his husband and tell her him that he can come back by my tea at home. So, the husband now carry his head and take that woman out.
Tell the mommy to leave the house. Or his wife.
His wife.
Wow.
So, and that wife was pregnant during that time.
Wow.
So the wife now leave the house around 9:30 p.m.
Wow.
So after that, they now settle the matter. Sha. So the mother still continue and talk nonsense around. One day, now talk about his own son. But the son said that he will send her to where she come from. And she,
okay,
son, come back.
Okay, ma.
But later
because we don't have all. I will answer that question, ma, because of time. We are limited to time. I've said it over and over again. There are five women in the life of every man. The wife, the senior sister, or the junior sister, one strange woman, the mother, and the daughter. Now, a woman must be smart enough to hold all of them. But like I said, for a man should protect his home. A man should protect his home. Because you know what? There are so many things you cannot do with your wife, with your mother. You understand? Your mother cannot have children for you. And you can't eat your cake and have it. So a man needs a lot of wisdom to handle their homes. In ability to let the mother know that, come. My mother, you are my mom. I love you. But this woman, anything she does, take her as your daughter. You know, in marriage, there is no communication. Where there is communication and everybody talks, people don't talk and it can be very, very embarrassing. In any relationship that there is no communication is going to be chaotic at the end of the day. If a woman has set a standard in that home, I say, Mom, my mother, this is my wife. I love my wife. I cannot exchange her for anything. Take her as your daughter. If she offends you, tell her. And I don't want to hear anything around the house. The woman will know that she's not coming to a place to scatter. And I used to tell mothers, please take care of your own home so that you not become a problematic mother-in-law and be scattering your children's home. Because if you have your own home and you take care of your husband, you take care of your family, nobody will see you as a nuisance. Please take care of your home. And please tell that woman to keep her home. It's her home. Are you getting me? And let me say to the man, a man should not push his wife away because of anything. Just use wisdom. The first thing, you know, I was ministering today. I said, some mothers, they use emotional blackmail. Ah, moji, ya, jemmy, so. There's no woman that does not suffer in her husband's house. Don't use that to turn the life of your son and make him very, very miserable. It's not fair. If you don't give your son peace in his home, it's not going to deliver. It's not going to make money. It's not going to bless you at the end of the day. Wow. Let's take one more call, can we? Oh, they said my time is up. As a matter of fact, I have everybody right in the studio. Once again, my name is Olufunke Adetuberu. This is She Matters with Olufunke. If you want to communicate with me, you can send me a text. Please don't call me. Well, we can't pick any calls any longer. You can call me on 080-232-42389. This is She Matters with Olufunke. On behalf of the CEO of this wonderful station, Evangelist Nkajuela Ifele, today is Tayo Faliti's birthday. Wishing her a very happy birthday. My name is still Olufunke Adetuberu. Thank you, DJ Shenkoka, for rounding me off intermittently. Thank you for taking care of me, Tolu. Thank you. I have my daughter in the house, Damola Adetuberu. I want to once again say a very big thank you to everyone who has been listening to us. Please don't forget to give that child a life. The account number, can Tolu please quickly read the account number? Can we do that? The account number is 00920-73848 Yinka Ayefele Diamond Bank, Ibadan. Please give that child life. Let him live. And it's going to be in your account. Once again, I want to say a very big thank you to all our listeners. I love you. You can send me a text on 080 232 42389. Please don't call, send me a text. Thank you so much. I'll see you next week.